Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. Education reform is underway in New Hampshire, but should businesses be paying attention? Take a look at these reforms that are underway, and some of these have been underway for several years. Next generation learning, 21st century learning, student-centered learning, and now core curriculum standards this fall in many schools across the state, especially in English and math. Now this quote from Dan Barrick, Deputy Director of the New Hampshire Center for Public Policy Studies, and my guest. All, and while this reform movement has gone largely unnoticed outside education circles, New Hampshire businesses should pay attention. With me is Dan Barrick. Welcome. Nice to have you.
Thank you, Fred.
Nice to have you. I'm going to read something you wrote back in April for the New Hampshire Business New Hampshire magazine. Just tied under that quote, the rest of that quote is, New Hampshire's no stranger to heated debates over public education. For nearly two decades, the state's school finance laws were center stage in the State House debates and in the courts. A very different aspect of education policy is now being considered in New Hampshire schools. Rather than funding formulas and tax laws, this effort centers on the classroom, how teachers and students communicate, how students' achievement is measured, and how to best prepare New Hampshire students for life after high school. But while this reform movement has gone quietly unnoticed outside of education circles, New Hampshire businesses should pay attention. Now that's a quote from your article this past April, but now the core curriculum is underway in New Hampshire schools. Why should New Hampshire businesses pay attention to all of this?
Well, first, I think one thing we said back in April, that a lot of this debate has gone unnoticed. I think with the introduction of the Common Core starting this school year, in the last few weeks, it really has come to the fore. But this is a big issue for the state as a whole, but in particular for businesses, I think for three main reasons. One is a very practical one, that a lot of the state level reforms that are meant to give students more practical experience and more practical application of their learning. One of the goals is to actually get students out into the community and get them into businesses where they can actually apply their content mastery and their new skills.
Right.
And if you talk with some schools with teachers and administrators, a lot of them will say, especially in rural parts of the state, making those connections to businesses or community groups is difficult. Second big reason is one you've talked about on this show, which is it's a workforce issue. A lot of folks have talked about the skills gap, the perceived gap between the business's needs for new openings, for new jobs, and the skills of the young workforce. I'll give you one example to illustrate that. New Hampshire has one of the highest levels of science and technology employees in our workforce, but it's also one of the oldest. Nearly one in four of those workers is over 55.
Right.
So how are we going to fill that gap as those men and women retire? And the third is simple quality of life.
Mm.
The quality of the school system plays a big part in the overall quality of life, the attractiveness of a community, and that's been a big part of the so-called New Hampshire advantage, and maintaining that's really important.
Well, let's show some graphs to the audience that you brought with you. Here's the first one, and don't worry about all the lines. Each line represents one of the 50 states in the United States. The red line is New Hampshire, and this is high school graduation rates by state for the most recent data we've had 2011. Dan, this one, and then the next one is the estimated percent of high school graduates going on to college, and you can see that the red line is on the left is New Hampshire, the red line on the right is the U.S. We're doing better than the U.S., but that is far cry from the percent graduating from high school. What's going on there?
Well, part of that is that when we talk about college there, we're talking both four-year and two-year, so both traditional four-year college as well as a community college. If we just looked at four-year college going rate, New Hampshire would fare a little bit higher. But in particular, the graduation rate, you show New Hampshire's, I think, fifth or sixth highest in the country, and there's a lot to be proud of there. But if you talk to educators and administrators, they'll tell you that the statewide data on a lot of education information in New Hampshire, the high statewide rankings mask a lot of disparity district by district and town by town.
School district by school district.
Yeah.
Yep.
So while on a statewide level we score fairly high on standardized tests, high graduation rates, there are many districts in the state that fall well below that, and that's a reason for concern, and that's an area of intense focus by a lot of this reform effort.
And by the business community as well.
Yep.
We're going to continue this discussion on education reform and businesses in New Hampshire going forward. Thank you to Dan Barrick from the Center for Public Policy Studies here in New Hampshire for this brief discussion, and we will follow this up with future interviews. You can see this interview again at WMUR.com. Click on News and then click on Project Economy.